of superstars of wrestling. The Ocean Center is only steps away from the Atlantic Shore and is host of such diverse events as the London Symphony, Ringling Brothers Circus, Alabama, and Disney's Magic Kingdom on Ice. Welcome, everyone, to the Superstars of Wrestling. I'm Vince McMahon, along with a man who certainly should have been one of the original Disney characters, along with Dumbo and perhaps Minnie the Mouse. Here, Jesse the Body Ventura.
You're really a smart mouth, McMahon. I just come in from chasing gators down in the Everglades. Let's get it on.
Well, we're going to be chasing a lot more than that. We have all kind of action for you this week.
In tonight's main event, the Rebel will meet the King. The Hammer will be in action.
Big John Studd and King Kong Bundy will both compete in singles competition.
And in a special Piper's Pit in honor of 3 years as World Wrestling Federation champion, we will see the Hulkster in a special presentation. I just want to take this opportunity to wish all our viewers a Happy New Year, and of course to wish you a Happy New Year also, Jesse.
Well, I'll tell you one man who's going to have a Happy New Year, and that's the Brain. In just a few short weeks, he may very well be managing the World Wrestling Federation Champion, the Intercontinental Champion, and the Tag Team Champions.
There certainly is that possibility, and we'll have more details on that a little bit later on. Sam Houston giving up a lot of size and weight to Rusty Brooks.
Well, Houston needs to move fast. He can't let Brooks get a hold of him.
And that is exactly what Houston is doing. Into the cover. No, too close to the ropes. Rusty Brooks now using his size and power to dominate Houston.
One, two.
And that was close.
Oh, backbreaker. And look out, here it comes.
No, nobody home.
Maneuver by Sam Houston.
One, two.
And that'll do it. No. Bulldog.
One, two.
He got him that time.
We'll be right back.
Sunday, January 26th, the World Wrestling Federation returns to pay-per-view for the Royal Rumble. 30 of the top World Wrestling Federation stars competing, but only one will survive. It's every man for himself. Whoa! Come on in, Outlaw Ron.
Too long off, is it, Mean Gene? You know something? You know, when you look out there down that curtain, it's going to be a rumble roll, baby. And what that is, they put numbers in a hat, and you reach in there, you grab one out, and if you're number one, brother, you got a long night ahead of you. But if you're number 20, you might just have it easy. It might slide right in there. But let me tell you something. There'll be no tag teams. There'll be nobody partners. It's all one-on-one. That means that you're going to have to be mean. You're going to have to be nasty. And you're going to have to be willing to do anything and in the shape of your life. What do you want? You keep bothering me.
I just want to point out a couple of things here, Ron Bass. The fact that, yes, we're going to start with numbers 1 and 2.
That's right.
Then every 2 minutes thereafter, another man will be added to the competition. But you can be eliminated, thrown over the top. It's going to be exciting.
I like throwing people over the top rope. I think that's how I'll be eliminating people, Mean Gene. Yes, it's going to be interesting. And if you're number one, you better be in shape, people, because you're going to be out there a long time, because there's 2 minute intervals, there's going to be more people coming in. So you know you're going to be out there 40 minutes. So let me tell you something. All you bad boys out there, I'm talking about Don Morocco, Jim Duggan, bunch of you guys, Sam Houston, all of you. You better kiss all the babies you want to. You better shake all the hands out there, because you're going to have to get in the ring and you're going to have to be facing everybody that wants to beat you. And Miss Betsy, please. She's going to be there and she'll be on my side. And you better believe it's a rumble roll and we're taking it.
All right, here's cranked up on Outlaw Ron Pat.
Greg the Hammer Valentine, a man who I dare say is going to have to deal with his former partner, Brutus Beefcake, now known as the Barber.
The Barber? Beefcake has gone off the deep end.
Perhaps he could be your barber, Jesse.
Ah, I go to Vidal Sassoon.
Yeah, but you don't go for very long. Valentine looking particularly aggressive here. I dare say Brutus Beefcake has gotten into the head of the Hammer.
Not possible. Greg Valentine is a consummate professional, always cool under pressure. And here it comes, the figure four.
He's got it cinched in, and that'll do it. Wait a minute. It's Beefcake. It's Brutus Beefcake. The Barber doing a number on the Hammer.
What a coward, back jumping the man after he's just had a match.
Valentine and Dino Bravo jumped Beefcake after a match, and he was supposed to be their partner.
Ladies and gentlemen, this contest is scheduled for one fall. Currently in the race, hailing from New Haven, Connecticut, weighing 245 pounds, Jerry Allen.
And look at the brain. He's on cloud nine come the Royal Rumble. He could well be the manager of the Tag Team Champions, the Intercontinental Champion, and the World's Champion.
He looks like he wants to get in the ring. Nonetheless, what you say is true, but I don't think it's very likely.
Never doubt the brain. And not only that, when it comes to the Royal Rumble match itself, you have to say that Big John Studd and King Kong Bundy are two of the heavy favorites.
Heavy being the operative word there.
Hey, it's a Royal Rumble. Who's going to pick those two guys up and toss them over the top rope?
Fair point.
And if they work together?
It's every man for himself, Jesse. You know that.
You think the brain isn't going to work strategically?
Well, I would suggest that things could get very interesting if it comes down to Studd and Bundy at the end. And there's the bear hug by Studd.
Too close to the ropes, otherwise this one was over.
And back into the bear hug. This time they're far enough away from the ropes.
There is a newcomer on his way to the World Wrestling Federation, and Jesse, I would suggest he is your kind of guy.
Well, for all you people out there who aren't familiar with me, let me introduce myself. I'm Ted DiBiase. I'm the Million Dollar Man. And you know, as I travel around this fair country of ours, I run into a lot of people who aren't happy with the way I spend my money. They say that money is the root of all evil. Well, I'm here to tell you that it's not. Because you see, with enough of this right here, I can buy anything. I can have anything I want. I can buy happiness. I can buy love. And if I want to, I can even buy you. Case in point, my man Virgil. Isn't that right, Virgil?
Yes, sir.
Virgil takes care of all of life's little problems that I don't have time to take care of him at all. See, if you've got a problem with me, Ted DiBiase,
and you will be,
or the way that I spend my money, you're just going to have to take it up with Virgil.
Ow! Virgil, I've cut my finger. I need medical attention. Get me to a doctor right now. Virgil, get me to a doctor. Get me to a doctor.
Yes, sir.
Nurse, I need immediate medical attention. I've hurt my finger and I need to see a doctor now.
Sir, I'm sorry. You've got to have an appointment.
Wait, you don't understand. I'm Ted DiBiase. I'm the Million Dollar Man. I don't need an appointment.
Sir, I've got sick people here waiting to see the doctor. You've got to make an appointment.
Virgil, can I see a doctor now?
No, sir.
Virgil,
Can I get some attention for this finger now?
Sir, I'm sorry.
Virgil, can I get a Band-Aid for this finger now?
Let me see what I can do, sir.
Hey, don't be upset with her. She did the same thing that anybody else in her position would have done. She did the same thing that you would have done. She had her price, just like each and every one of you have your price. Everybody's got a price for the $1 million man.
$1 million man Ted DiBiase on his way to the World Wrestling Federation, and I have to wonder just how equipped for it he will be if he needs to see a doctor for a paper cut on his finger.
Hey, those paper cuts are a chronic problem for him considering how often he's counting bills. And believe me, this man is a very accomplished wrestler. He's had the best training money can buy.
So you two are familiar with one another?
We move in similar circles, Hollywood parties, exclusive clubs, things like that.
Of course. Gargantuan King Kong Bundy, definitely one of the favorites for the upcoming Royal Rumble match. Good night.
Did you see the air Bundy got on that big splash?
Let's go now to Sean Mooney, who is standing by in the event center.
Sunday, January 26th, the World Wrestling Federation returns to pay-per-view for the Royal Rumble. Featuring the Royal Rumble match itself, 30 of the top World Wrestling Federation superstars in one ring, entering at two-minute intervals. The only way to eliminate an opponent is to throw him over the top rope and onto the floor. The last man standing after all 30 participants have entered will be the winner. There are no friends, only foes. And in addition to the Royal Rumble match itself, the Intercontinental title will be up for grabs as the Macho Man, Randy Savage, defends against the mighty Hercules.
Competitive spirit, yeah. And I, the Macho Man, Randy Savage, with a competitive spirit, I'm going to go after you, Hercules, yeah, because you're not going to make your manager, Bobby Heenan, happy over taking the Macho Man, Randy Savage. Did I say that right there?
Yeah. I think you said
man,
it.
And we're talking, yeah. And I am ready, yeah.
You know, one thing, Macho Man, that I've noticed, it was pointed out to me by Elizabeth, that you've acquired somehow over the past 2 or 3 months, and I can't believe it. You've acquired, I don't know, what would you call it, spunk.
That's it right there. You got it. Yeah, I am more spunky, yeah, spunky. Lately. Yeah, spunky lately versus, yeah, different people. And I got that spunky type momentum. And it's going to be spunky versus Hercules.
At the Royal Rumble.
1, 2, 3. Big elbow, yeah.
All right, that's the Royal Rumble, January 26th on pay-per-view. Intercontinental title on the line.
The World Wrestling Federation tag team titles will be on the line when the British Bulldogs defend against Bobby Heenan's Islanders.
Islanders, you better get ready because you're facing the British Bulldogs and we're in the best shape of our life. And Matilda's getting ready. She's just pretending right now, but that very well could be Bobby the Brain Heenan's leg.
Before we arrive at the Royal Rumble on January 26th, the World Wrestling Federation returns to primetime on NBC for Saturday night's main event on Saturday, January 11th. And in the main event, World Wrestling Federation champion Hulk Hogan will put his title on the line against the King of Wrestling, Harley Race.
I'm going to get him in here right away. Heavyweight champion of the world.
Saturday night's main event on primetime. You'll take on
the King of Wrestling, Harley Race, and Hulk after what happened the last time at the Boston Garden.
No love lost between the two of you.
Well, now they're finally starting to understand why I got to the mountaintop, why I stayed so intense. You know, sometimes when you get it all, people back off. But it's harder to keep it, man. The whole world watching, the largest arms in the world raised in victory. No, I didn't back off, man. That's why the sweat turns into rivers in the gym. That's why the intensity turns into laser beams. And after what went down in Boston, brothers, the Hulkster's been holding some private training session with my main man, Pat Catena, a world's gym, brother, and Harley Race, the King. I hope you get the whole board loaded with all the weasel's men and all the weasel's horses. What do you want?
Hulk, I've just got to bring it up. You know, in private conversation and even publicly here on television, Bobby Heenan and Harley Race have suggested if they should, by some fluke, upset you and arrest the world's heavyweight crown, they would ask you to bow at the King's feet. Can you believe that?
They have to break my back in half. All I got to say, it's almost like insanity. There's no way out for you dudes. All my Hulkamaniacs know what's going down. And when I get the chance, given point in time, I hope you, Weasel, and Harley Race are ready to be disgraced. I want the crown on my head and both of you punks at my feet.
Oh, he is tuned up for this one. Get ready.
Saturday night's main event.
Hulk Hogan to defend against the King Harley Race.
In a six-man tag team encounter, Barry Windham and Mike Rotunda will team with Sam Houston to take on the Magnificent Morocco and Demolition. And it has been confirmed in a grudge match between the former World Tag Team Champions, Brutus the Barber Beefcake, will meet Greg the Hammer Valentine. Stay tuned in the coming weeks for more information on the Royal Rumble and Saturday night's main event. Now back to the action.
Take a good look, McMahon. We may well be looking at the next World Wrestling Federation champion.
Quite possibly, although my money is on the Hulkster. The Rebel's certainly not a man to be taken lightly. Turnabout is fair play for the Rebel.
For someone like Dick Slater, knowing that Harley Race may well become the next world's heavyweight champion, a win for Slater here would put him right in line for a title shot, should Race win it.
Race going up.
Connected.
Into the cover.
One, two.
Almost.
Suplex.
He took too long to make the cover. He can't afford that kind of arrogance when he faces the Hulkster at Saturday night's main event.
Shoulder breaker.
Referee, get in there. He's in the ropes. Race is such an intelligent wrestler, he never gets flustered and he has a counter for everything. And to top it all off, he's incredibly aggressive, truly world champion material.
Yeah, well, he's got to pin the Hulkster or make him submit. And I just don't think it can be done. And speaking of the Hulkster, he is up next for a special presentation in Piper's Pit. Sends him in, big clothesline.
Oh, and that patented knee lift.
And still there is fight left in the rebel.
But look at that, he didn't even get a one count on Race. And there's the pile driver, this one is over.
And possibly the most important pit I have ever done in my life.
obviously, we have here a presentation, and to do the presentation, I would like the president of the
WWF,
Jack Tunney, to please come on out here and issue this presentation.
Thank you.
Pleasure to have you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're delighted to help honor a very special man on a very special occasion. Let me read what it says on this trophy. 3 years ago this month, you captured
the WWF
Heavyweight Championship belt in a memorable battle. You are one of the greatest professional athletes in the history of sports. You are a champion who has raised wrestling to heights never before scaled. You are one of America's most patriotic citizens. You are loved and idolized by men, women, and children of all ages. You are the single most recognizable star in the entire world. We salute you on the third anniversary of your reign. Let's all honor the one and only Hulk Hogan!
This has got to stick in Piper's craw. This is sickening.
It's yours.
Unbelievable. You know, January 23rd, 1984, when I won the world title, I knew there was something special, man. I knew there was some kind of electricity. But I never believed 3 long years down the road, thousands of people just like you would all turn into Hulkamaniacs and to receive an award for something that I believe in, the training, the saying the prayers, the eating the vitamins, to be rewarded for living this thing, this is unbelievable. This has got to be just as great as when I won the world title. This is going to be just as great as the first time I saw you Hulkamaniacs. And from here, it's higher and higher we go. This is unbelievable. Unbelievable.
Wow! Ladies and gentlemen, Hulk Hogan's best friend, Andre the Giant! I'm sure you have come here for congratulations, and I'm sure you have something to say.
3 years to be a champion, it's a long time.
It's a long time, yeah. Well, nice trophy, a nice trophy here. There you go, Hogan. There's to you.